Recently, Charger Lab has gotten a new ASUS ALO 100W GaN charger, a fast charger with 3 USB-C ports and 1 USB-A port. Let's have a detailed review. The package includes the charger and the manual. The charger is black and green. It adopts foldable prongs. There is the specification. The ASUS ALO AC10001 supports the input of 100 to 240 volts, 50 or 60 Hz, 2.5 amps. The USB-C1 or C2 output is from 5 volts, 3 amps to 20 volts, 5 amps. USB-C3 output is from 5 volts, 3 amps to 12 volts, 1.5 amps. The USB-A output is from 4.5 volts, 5 amps to 12 volts, 1.5 amps. It has 3 black USB-C ports and 1 orange USB-A port. The size is about 75x60x29mm and the power density is about 0.66 watts per cubic centimeter. The weight is about 213 grams. ChargerLab PowerZ KM002C finds that the USB-C1 supports AFC, FCP, SCP, QC 3.0, and PD 3.0 protocols and 5 fixed PDOs of 5 volts 3 amps, 9 volts 3 amps, 12 volts 3 amps, 15 volts 3 amps, 20 volts 5 amps. The USB-C2 supports AFC, FCP, SCP, QC 3.0, PD 3.0, and PPS protocols, and it supports 5 fixed PDOs of 5 volts 3 amps, 9 volts 3 amps, 12 volts 3 amps, 15 volts 3 amps, 20 volts 5 amps, and 1 PPS of 3.32 21 volts 5 amps. The USB-C3 supports the same protocols as the USB-C1, and it also supports 3 fixed PDOs of 5 volts 3 amps, 9 volts 2.22 amps, 12 volts 1.5 amps. First, let's have a charging compatibility test. The USB-C1 supports 100 watts PD but no PPS, so the Apple devices have the highest power, and Android devices are generally 10 watts to 20 watts. The USB-C2 performs better when charging Android devices because of the PPS. The USB-C3 supports 20 watts fast charging, so the power of different devices differs very little. The USB-A port supports Huawei SCP fast charging, so the Huawei phones perform better. When the four ports are outputting at the same time, the C1 and C2 share the 60 watts, and the C3 and A ports share the 503 amps. Since the charger supports 100 watts output, we used it to fully charge the MacBook Pro 16 2021. The whole charging process can be roughly divided into 4 parts and finally ended in 2 hours and 5 minutes with a maximum power of 19.11 volts, 4.53 amps, 86.7 watts. The curve shows that the charger charges 40% in 30 minutes, 77% in 1 hour, and it takes about 2 hours and 5 minutes to fully charge the MacBook Pro 16 2021. Now, let's have a standby power test. The power meter shows that the standby power consumption of the charger at 220 volts 50 Hz is 0.094 watts, which equals about 0.82 kilowatt hour in a year. At 110 volts 60 Hz, it is 0.027 watts, equaling about 0.23 kilowatt hour 1 year. The lower the value of the standby power consumption, the better. So the charger has a good performance at both 220 volts and 110 volts. The conversion efficiency of the charger varies from 79.14% to 91.67% at 220 volts 50 Hz and 78.79% to 19.4% at 110 volts 60 Hz. The conversion efficiency shows the quality of the charger. The higher the percentage, the better. It is among the highest in some 100 watts PD chargers. The ripple test is divided into no load and loaded. With no load at 220 volts 50 Hz, when the output is 5 volts 0 amp, the highest ripple is 40. And when the output is 15 volts 0 amp, the lowest ripple is 16. At 110 volts 60 Hz, when the output is 5 volts 0 amp, the highest ripple is 40. And when the output is 20 volts 0 amp, the lowest ripple is 16. When loaded at 220 volts 50 Hz, when the output is 12 volts 2 amps and 15 volts 2 amps, the highest ripple is 80, and when the output is 5 volts 3 amps, the lowest ripple is 48. at 110 volts 60 Hz when the output is 12 volts 2 amps and 15 volts 2 amps, the highest ripple is 56. And when the output is 5 volts 2 amps, 5 volts 3 amps, 15 volts 3 amps, and 20 volts 5 amps, the lowest ripple is 48. Here comes the temperature test. We put it into a 25 degree thermal tank throughout the test and let it run for an hour with the power of 100 watts. An hour later, the maximum temperature on the A and the B sides was 63.6 degrees under 220 volts 50 Hz, and the maximum temperature on the C and D sides was 69.3 degrees. Under 110 volts 60 Hz, the maximum temperature on the A and the B sides was 71.5 degrees, and the maximum temperature on the C and the D sides was 66 degrees. Clearly, the temperature is higher under 110 volts and lower under 220 volts. Well, that's all for the tests of this charger. The new ASUS AIDO 100W GaN charger used the GaN technology to make it smaller and more portable. With 3 USB-C ports and 1 USB-A port, it meets the different needs of various devices, and it's compatible with Android devices, Apple devices, and laptops. Okay, that's all for today's video. Please drop a like, leave a comment, and subscribe to us, and I'll catch you guys in the next video. Bye!